spot on, right? Jayla, what did you say it was about? Was it like that? No. We use close. I like how you use the word break. You can go ahead. So overall, what was the article about?
People not having jobs.
Good. They didn't have jobs. They were homeless. What else?
They closed the banks.
They closed the banks. What else happened? Josiah.
People started.
Jeremiah.
People started getting feed and they had changes.
They had to get
every day they would pay 85,000 cups of food.
You remember that statistic, right? Why did people stop buying things in the late 1920s? RJ?
Because they were broke.
Because they were broke. Was it because they were broke?
No.
It was kind of because they were broke. Maybe they were able to pay for things. How did World War II help the economy? Just said it. People got jobs after the Great Depression because they needed people to help make stuff for the war, right? So then all the people who didn't have jobs now had jobs. And then you wanted to answer questions?
Yeah, I
wanted to. Oh. Okay, so like yesterday, we're gonna do the gist. I'm gonna do the first gist with you guys. And then you guys are going to read with your partner.
I'll have one.
Okay, Isaiah, go ahead and move with Daniel. And then you're gonna work with them again. Or no, you'll work with Funny Soul.
Huh?
Over.
Everybody has a partner then?
Yeah.
No. I don't.
Stop. All right, Anila. Did you want to read?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead and read the first paragraph. Everybody's quietly following along. Hold on. Wait till everybody's quiet. Thank you, RJ. Josiah. Thank you, Brian. All right, Anila, go ahead.
When World War officially ended in 1919, America was out of the war and ready for good times. In the early 1920s, there was plenty of jobs in the United States. People earned good income. Businesses grew quickly during the roaring 20s. America
by the end of 1920,
warehouses were filled up. up with merchandise that no one bought. Fashion can just slow down. Many factors that we lost their jobs.
Good. And that was it.
Alright,
so thinking, what is the overall key points of this paragraph? Jayla? Put the dry erase marker away.
Then the 1920s, we're not supposed to show the merchandise, but no one wanted to buy it because the factories had it.
Sorry, there's some talking and coming.
That in the 1920s, there were warehouses. They were filled up with merchandise, but no one had bought them because they had lost their jobs, so they couldn't hold them.
Okay. That's like towards the end, though. What about all of this stuff that happened up here? Is it talking about the warehouses being filled up?
No.
No? Teresa?
They were talking about how Americans were tired of...
Anila, stop talking. Go ahead.
They were ready for good times, so they started spending money. They started getting more Americans started getting jobs.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just a good time.
It was a good time.
But they started spending a lot of money on large items for the house, like washing machines, cars, clothes,
Okay, but think about, we're trying to get our gist. So all of those ideas, try and simple them down. Clarissa?
Before the Great Depression, everyone had a job, everyone had a lot of money. But then when the Great Depression hit, many people lost their jobs.
Yes, so you're saying almost the same thing as Teresa, right? That they had a job after the war and then they started buying more things. So what if we say something, or did you want to add something?
Yeah.
No, so no. What if we say, I'm going to simple down what you guys said, you guys were right. What if we do, the gist of this paragraph is after World War I, they started buying a lot of things, but then they made too much stuff, right? That's what people stop buying, right? Would you guys agree with that? Is there anything else you would want to add?
Yeah.
What?
The storm?
To just the gist. We're just missing the first paragraph.
So this is there. I thought you were talking about the shop. Is there anything else at the store? All I said that.
Oh. Hold on. Your mind's not done.
Because I thought you said that you want to add anything to the thing. You said that they had so many things in the store, right?
Yeah. That's
so
a good point to add. That it wasn't just too many things. It was mainly things that were in the store. Or, Teresa, you said warehouses, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Jayla, what were you saying?
Mm-hmm.
What were you saying?
I was going to say that there was plenty of jobs in the United States where people could earn good income.
Okay. And that helped them buy a lot of things, right? Because you can't buy anything if you don't have money and you need money from your job, right? So my gist is going to be after. And again, you guys can add those key ideas that you guys talked about. It's going to help you. But I'm going to write after World War I, and this is an abbreviation. So just W is World War I. Later on, we're going to talk about World War II, and we would have two lines. After World War I, people in the U.S. bought a lot of things.
Bought a lot of things?
Mm-hmm.
But then...
glad that, like, war is kind of violent. Not everybody likes to send their loved ones away, because then you miss them, right? So after the war, everybody came back, and we had won the war. So everybody was excited, and you guys, you pay attention, Jeremiah. After the war, everybody was excited, and so that's why they called it the Roaring Twenties.
But do they still do war today?
Yeah, we'll talk about that another
time. It's over.
We'll talk about it later. But the world after World War I, everybody was excited, and so they were partying a lot. That's why they called it the Roaring Twenties. So if you guys have ever seen the movie Gatsby, that's the Roaring Twenties. That's really popular. But then, like, we see everybody was super excited, so they bought a lot. They had a bunch of money because they all got jobs when they came back, and they bought a lot. But then they made too much.
I already did mine. Mine is kind of long.
Okay.
They made too much money?
No, they made too much merchandise. They made too many products.
It was like if they went like up and down and up and down, and so they went to down.
Girl,
what?
Never make this.
Anila,
it's me.
I already told you. Stop touching her stuff.
It's me.
And then I left. You can ask politely. Stop. I'm not. This isn't a discussion. I'm talking to you. Somebody left. All right. Go ahead and write your gist down. Everybody should have their gist written down.
No.
I'm not selfie.
Open a random group.
So if you guys were here yesterday, you guys read with your partner and completed the gist together. You guys are gonna do the same thing today.
What?
I'm gonna tell you right now. Okay. I'm waiting for Adira. Just like go back to your desk. Hey, I know some people just came in.
Oh,
Marisol. And I like those sort of one of the wiggly tables or wiggly stools. Hold on. Those that just came in, go ahead and write the gist. Yes, Clarissa.
Wait, did I forget?
So we just finished. Hold on, guys. I can't hear Clarissa. Can you stop talking? Okay. You guys are in pairs. I just regrouped you guys. You're going to write the gist for paragraph one.
Paragraph one.
Paragraph one's gist is on the board. So write it now. And I'm going to put it away. Those of you that just came in need to hurry. Anila, give her rings back. Or you're going to work on yourself. Or work by yourself. Yes. So I know some of you guys weren't here. We had quite a few absences yesterday. There are seven. Look up here. Stop. Give it to her now and go sit down. There are a total of seven paragraphs. We just did just one. So how many paragraphs do we have left to just?
Six.
There are two of you. There might be, I think I have one group of three. So one person is gonna read. I'm gonna have Marisol read paragraph two. Then they're going to talk together about what the gist is. What was the overall key points? And then Desiree is going to read paragraph three. Who's going to read paragraph four?
Me. Marisol.
Marisol. Who's going to read paragraph five?
Desiree.
Every time you guys read one paragraph, I want you to write the gist for that paragraph and then move on to the next one so you don't forget what happened. Okay? Understand?
Yeah.
Fernando, understand?
I do want you guys to have enough time to do your Padlet. There is a Padlet for this. So we're going to stop the gist. I really, really, really don't want to because you guys are working so well together. You can stay in your seats if that's going to help you. But if somebody else wants to go back to their seat, you got to respect that, okay? We're going to move on to the multiple choice on the next page. Go ahead and get your multiple choice, or go ahead and get your whiteboards out.
Good.
Yeah.
paragraph 7 of what was the Great Depression?
Yes, C.
Lord of Worship.
See, a lot of all this is C, C, A, C, B, a D. Wait. All right.
Hey.
To meet the strong need, about context clues, right?
Yeah.
This even tells us where we can find our context clues. Where can we find our context
clues? And paragraph six.
Paragraph six.
So I know what unemployment is.
So you have heard right before is like percentage. So I'm gonna say the phrase unemployment rate refers to. Somebody give me a definition of unemployment rate. Nestle.
Refers to like either what happens who is in who does not have a job.
Is it somebody or what about rate? Is rate meaning one person?
No.
Hold on. Teresa.
Meaning that what people don't have jobs.
People?
So rate would mean the percentage of people that don't have jobs. In employment,
people. Think more about rate. Look at what I.
That's like the percentage of people who don't have jobs.
Yeah, I like that. The percentage of people who do not have jobs. Percentage, you want to add? No? And anybody else? Do you guys agree? The percentage of people who don't have jobs?
Yeah.
Does anybody disagree?
No.
I do. I disagree, though. Orlando, thank you for raising your hand quietly.
Huh?
What did you want to add?
Oh, no, I just put my hand up.
Okay, my soul.
A rate of people not having a job.
A rate of people not having a job? Manila? Refers to the percentage. Nobody should be talking right now. You guys should not be ready.
That's what we're talking about.
Walking feet.
She said walking feet.
Someone just unlock it.
Stop.
So you guys are supporting your